Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Milo's Games, and today I want to show you an amazing game called Dungeon Tomb. I've been playing this game on and off. I believe it's still in early access, though I'm not so sure, but it's great. Either way, even if it is in early access or not, it's well worth your time. It is interesting by all metrics. So I'm going to lower a little bit the sound and the music. Music like here is good, I believe. Game speed, that or everything is fine. Save and quit and continue. No. I was playing a little bit of the game to refamiliarize a little bit with the mechanics and everything, and it has changed a lot from the last time that I played the game, and I believe it has been for the better. There is like a new character, there are more cards, they streamline a little bit more, like the leveling up your character. Like, we're going to get into all those details right now, so well, I don't care what was the progress of the last round. Like, I don't care. So what we're going to do is like explain a little bit what the hell is going on here. So you start the game choosing your champion. This is like your main card. Also, by the way, this is a like deck builder roguelite by the way, and pretty similar to Slay the Spire in the way that there's a deck that you're building, like all the deck builders. You're probably seen more of the likes of like Monster Train, that's a good one as well, this one, you have your champion, your main card, and if your champion loses all health, you lose, but you have also like all the other cards that are going to support your champion. You can choose different alliances, like you have the Hand of the Carrion and Tribes of the North, and it's really good. Hopefully I'm not like blocking anything in the screen. No, I'm not. Yeah, you can choose also like different like categories, like types of starting decks. Yeah, starting decks like the Prowlers, the Beast, and the basics. So we're going to start playing with the basics of the Warrior class, the easiest one to learn at the beginning, and we're just going to go straight into the game. Vrognir the Berserker is fine. Like, I don't have the creativity at the moment to come up with something more funny. The damn things nest here that have not seen sunlight for centuries. The stench of waste permeates the air, and your eyes take time to adjust to the light. As you peer into the darkness, the food chain of the dungeon plays out before your eyes in real time, as a blind rodent is snatched into the darkness by a pale green hand. The rat's last squeak is silenced by an echoing crunch. Okay, so this is pretty much like the darkest dungeon like layout. Like, you start by choosing your path, which at the moment is like not pretty much choosing, because you have only like a set of path that you need to take in order for complete like the dungeon. Also, by the way, we're going to change my face and we're going to put it right here, because I'm blocking like the main part of my character, like the experience bar. There is right here, I say, it's right here, and the treasures, the healing potions, our money, and the flare stones. There are a little bit of a currency that you get to get more cards after each encounter, and we're going to just go straight into it. Also, we're not going to play like a full playthrough of all like this dungeon, because it would be like an hour long, so I will leave that up to you. But this game is pretty fun. So we can discard the cards that we don't want at the moment, and this card is like the bald dude is not really that good, But here the archer, like the helm slingman, is pretty good. We're going to see what each card does. So here is like the big, like interesting part about the game, is that this is our champion. Each champion has like stats. If you see, the power is the amount of damage that you have, your HP, your actions, and your moves. The moves is how much you can move in the table, so how many blocks you can move, and the action is just how much you can attack, basically, if you can attack once or twice. So my champion at the moment can attack one and can move one, but when you just put a card into the scene, into the table, like they can't move or attack unless they have the specific ability to do so. You on the top here, you can see the mana cost, their life, and their attack. And in this card is especially interesting because he has range, and he has range too. It means that up until two like blocks here, you can attack someone. So you can summon only adjacent to other units. So you can have like a little bit of a more like interesting mechanics. Also, I did this completely wrong because I have this card right here that it has a warcry that adds one power to itself and to adjacent units you control. So if I was a little bit smarter or paying more attention, also we could put it here and we could put our champion right here and we could put this unit in the middle and we will get more damage. One more power for everybody, and that's permanent for the run. And this one is a block, which means that if I put it on a unit, it's going to negate each damage, all the damage for one action. So let's just put it right there, and then we can't do anything else with our turn. And that's pretty much like the basics of the game. Like the starting deck is pretty good for the introduction for the mechanics, but there are plenty of deep mechanics going on here, and it's pretty satisfying when you get this. For example, is a spell that if I land it, nothing is going to happen, right? It's just damage. Yeah, deal 2 damage to an enemy. You see, it's straightforward, but there sometimes like you do damage and then you can draw a card, and more nuances than this vanilla deck builder. This is especially like a great card because each turn is going to get better and better. We're just going to surround the champion unit, which we need to kill in order to advance to the next stage. So I can't do anything else. He killed one of my dudes and he took 2 damage because this card, if someone moves into their area, like in this area, they're going to take damage. So the more damage this unit has, is going to have more power for defending, right? So we're going to probably just use this spell because we don't have any better, we don't have anything better to do with it, and we're just going to attack and attack and attack, and we're going to attack again. You can move after the attack. So here we have victory. We have our loot, we gain experience, and we can choose new cards for our deck. So I don't particularly like anything from here, especially because these cards but this card is upgraded. So it might be good to just select it. So this card has little HP, and when he dies, it's going to give me a javelin, and a javelin is going to deal 2 damage. So this card is just a basic unit that hopefully you make it die in a controlled manner so you can get the javelin. All right, so we can get up to 2 cards for free, but I'm not really interested in anything besides this. I rather just pick upgraded cards in my strategy, just because otherwise I'm going to have to spend too much in making them good or viable. So if we go to the blacksmith, we're going to be able to upgrade the cards. And the card that I want to upgrade the most at the moment is not this one. It's going to get one more HP, which is not like that big of a deal. But if we can get the Rager better, it's going to be awesome. Because this card gets better every turn, so you can... If you have a long fight, this is going to be awesome. So now, if we want to upgrade it further, because we already upgraded once, we're going to need to use a treasure. And the treasures are like special cards, special items or artifacts that are attached to you, that if you use them, you can use them to get money, and with that money you buy cards after the game. But if you want to invest the things that you already have, you can also like upgrade your cards for the run. So we're going to do especially that, and we're going to get like the maximum. We're going to have like a great champion. And for my understanding, if your card dies in the battlefield, they get sent to your discard pile, and then you can shuffle them into your deck. So you can, if your unit dies, it's not like the end of the world. Unless like there is an enemy that specifically tells you that if it's killed by them, it's going to get exhausted from your deck. So this is like a great game. And from here on out, hopefully I explain a little bit more rationale behind my decisions. But that's it. Like, rinse and repeat. Like, this game is pretty good. Pretty good. We don't have anything else to do. Alright, you killed my guy. Could I have prevented that? Probably. Most likely. Am I going to feel sad about it? No. We're going to move here. We're going to attack with this, and look at this pro play. We're going to put this unit to buff all the adjacent units. We're going to kill this boy, and we're going to do damage to this boy right here, and we're going to protect the most valuable card right here, because this is our champion. We don't want him to die just yet. He has stuff to do. See? So he has no chance of recovering from this. And the fights are really short for the moment. Those are like 2 minute fights, 3 minute fights. Whoa! Three-headed hellhound, power 2, hit point 3, multi-strike. Multi-strike, your unit can perform additional action each turn, including attacks. So we're going to get this one because it's buffed to the maximum, and we're going to see if we can buff it with some talents or with that unit that buffs other units. I'm really awful at remembering the card names, so that's good. I mean, that's not good. That's how I am. I just the guy that buffs other units. So here we level up. We gain 3 HP, we can select a talent. In the past, you choose like a path. You have like a path that you can select your talents, but here it's more streamlined, they're random, it's more dynamic, you don't know what you're going to get, which I believe it's better. Give adjacent minions 1 power. I don't know about that. If you don't spend all your mana in one turn, gain 1 mana to the next turn. That can potentially be great. And I believe I'm going to go for that one, because not always we're going to have the chance to spend all our mana. You find a pack of downcast minions shattering in a dark room. They look to you as you come in, eyes brimming with hope. Choose which minions to take. Alright, let's take them. And I regret my decision immediately. She has multi-strike, range. While adjacent friendly minions have 1 ignite, which means like a fire at the start of the turn, they will take a fire damage. I believe we'll go for this one, range 2, multi-strike. If we buff this unit, it can potentially be like devastating for the team. So the next unit that we're going to buff is going to be that one. We're going to have, I believe, everything except this boy in play. Oh, but will it be the right decision to free the three-headed hellhound? I believe it's not the wisest of decisions at the moment. We're going to build up a little bit more our defense, because if he moves towards us, we're going to attack them, and hopefully it turns out to be like the good decision. We're going to just spend the damage. I mean, throw the javelin to our opponent to do a little bit of more damage. So we need to attack these boys right here. It's needed. It's important. We're going to throw this unit to buff everybody. And if this unit moves right here, it's dead. So I don't want it to. It can't shoot my champion, so I'm going to move towards here. And let's go right here. This unit is just there to die. Let's just be honest about it. And we're going to. Alright, we're going to protect our Mountain Master. That's how it's called, right? See? It died because of him. It was the best decision. So, can we actually kill? Oh, I believe we can't. No, I did it wrong. Or did I? We're going to. Maybe we can attack with this boy. Yes, we can. And if we can, we can summon this boy. We can attack the champion. And then we throw the javelin and we won. Just like that. In two turns. Two turns? Maybe? I don't remember. So here we have treasures. And this is a card, basically. That you can also use to upgrade your other cards. You give a unit 3 plus power. That's awesome. We're going to go for that one. This is also a unit that could be very beneficial for us. It's going to increase its power by the number of units we have in control and in play. So it's like really good. We're going to go for that one, and we're spending flare stones, and we also going to have like a new weapon. So this will make our champion specifically like a range unit. So we spent like a lot to get a lot. So it was fine in my opinion. And then that there is like our weapon. So arching. It means that you can't kill or attack adjacent units immediately. You need to have like a block of distance between your opponent. So I want to really upgrade this unit to see what's up. And I'm going to just do it, because I believe it's going to be like our carry. Having multi-strike is really beneficial. And if it has like more damage, it can kill enemies really quickly. So hopefully you're liking the game. Like, I like it a lot. The aesthetics, like the my idea might left something to desire to some people. I can see that, but for me, like, the core gameplay is like just so satisfying. Also, I forgot I don't want the hellhound immediately in like our possession. And also I did this completely wrong. I should have put them in like an order, and I apologize, but at the same time it already happened. What can I do? Forgive me. That's a problem That's a big problem because I believe it can, no, it can't reach me if I'm here, but I can reach them. So what I'm going to do is like go here, attack my fellow lizardman, and just try to block his path so he can't really attack me. That's what I fear. So if he wants to attack me, he's going to have to do work. And there we have our champion. Hopefully he's not get targeted by our opponent. And in the next turn, we're likely going to get, yeah, this buff. And I believe he's dead. Like, there is absolutely no way he can protect himself. We already have in the table the damage needed to attack him. But look, one, two, and I have like an action, one more action. Yeah, three. We can do 12 damage if we have that combination. And also we can keep like, that's not an exhausted spell. Like, we can keep buffing if we shuffle quickly enough. So it's good. I didn't like any of that. Sorry if I did a little bit too quickly. What else? Ignite plus one. I'm not interested in that. That might be better because we're going to have like, our unit is going to be always, our champion is always going to be protected. So giving more damage to the people that are protecting their champion is more beneficial than with the things that we already have going on. So here is like something that I like a lot. Removing cards that I don't like. The first one is for free, always. And do I have another treasure? I don't, so we're just going to back down and we're going to go here and we're going for a normal path. And as you step through the portal, you hear screeching of gears and deep rumble as the giant door to the next room opens before you. So, well, there is not really like a lot of options at the moment in terms of choosing your path. You're just going through a straight path and you're deciding the order to do things. You can also see the deck of your opponent and you can strategize a little bit more if you have different weapons. You can plan ahead what you're going to do. But I am not doing that. I have not played the game also nearly enough to know what's the best course of action. But we are going to redraw those two cards that I don't like enough. So we're going to put this boy here. How do we do it? There is absolutely no way in which I can buff this unit because I already did it wrong, right? Also, how much? He has 3 range, so we need to stop him from, how much you can move? Only 1. So we need to stop him from going into this direction. So we're actually going to go in this weird line, because if he goes all the way here and he attacks me, I'm going to be a sad boy. So we're not going to buff any unit at the moment. It's not necessary. It is necessary. We're going to buff a unit. Forget everything that I said. Protect our boy. Attack. Okay. We can't do anything else. That's our girl. Ooh. I believe we won. Yep. Just like that. See, this game is like really fun. It's like the fights are short, but they can go wrong really quickly, especially if you go to a next floor. And this is pretty nice. We're going to beat the boss And for that, I need to be a little bit quick, because this is already turning out to be like a long video. But that's okay. No one is rushing us. Yeah, let's go for that. Can I buff this unit? I definitely can. Never knew. That's a good thing. Let's protect. I don't know why. There's no need for using that that spell. We're going to go. No. We're going to do this the smart way. We're going to put our best champion right there. We're going to move the Pac-Man there, and we're going to buff everyone, absolutely everyone, and then see how many units we have here. And we're going to put this boy right here, and he's going to have 8 damage. Maybe this is our big boy, the Helm Sturdy. That's good. All right. So there is absolutely no way we can lose. There is absolutely no way we can lose. Our boys are really great at doing like plenty of damage. Next turn, he's done. And I don't know, we can keep just putting more cards into the battlefield. It's not going to change the fact that he's going to die. Boom. Oh no. She doesn't have that much range. Now that I think about it. Oh no! He managed to get away for a little bit. Alright, next turn you kill him, right? Alright. I messed up. I could have killed him in a faster manner. But he's dead. Because she has range 2, yeah, range 2. Boom. That's such a good unit. I want to upgrade it one more time. Another pikeman? No. It's tempting, but no. We don't get like 3 of the same card in a deck. We should probably start to thin in a little bit more the deck. Like, this is an okay start. Pac-Man. This, and this, and this. And there it is. That's the right way of tackling that scene. So we're going to develop the vicious multi-bow, and if we stay just like this, they're going to take damage, because if they approach us in this direction, it's going to be bad for them. And I don't care if you die, you're dead actually, just for that. We're going to develop this. How do we do it? Here. 8. That's a good damage. Oh, but if they die, they also lower the damage of our boy. Uh-oh. Okay. Uh-oh. They're actually getting buffed. I probably should have read the description, right? do your damage. I know that I could be doing a little bit more, but this is enough, I believe. Oh no, they're dead. I didn't see the right play there. This unit is also really good. And you? Multi-strike. That's really good. You have only 2 hit points of damage, you don't have any range. But you're really good, but this is actually like insanely good. If I can upgrade it one more time, I would be legendary in the dungeon top scene. That's not good enough. No, you're not needed. You're also not needed, and you're also not needed. Actually, there is only one good card in that the whole thing. Unit, until the end of your next turn, your minions gain 1+ dash. So he's going to move two times. That's not good. Do I develop this girl? The vicious multiball, I believe we need to. So we don't have more choice. He didn't move. No, he's going to move on the next turn. Okay. It's a good thing that we have the upgrade there. How is it called? Into the Fray number 2. Okay, we're slowly, but we're getting close to our enemies. And we're going to protect it. This unit is the one that I like to protect the most because it has the most potential to develop. It has like a good amount of health points. So, yeah, it was the right choice. We save up one point of damage. So we're going to do like a big rain strategy. We're going to put this boy right here, the Ver Pact cultist. We're going to move our parkman here and we're going to buff him, and he's going to be able to kill. I forgot that if they're adjacent to me, they're going to get more damage. So let's start doing a little bit more damage. And he's down. There's nothing he can do. Not even close. There we go. Loot. Not a card that interests me at the moment. And this one is really good. Mana, always go for the mana. Being able to summon more cards is really, really important in this type of game. Okay, this is an elite. Not too worried about the situation. Okay. Redraw. And now that we have more space, we're going to summon 3 cards. You. No. And you. We're going to be behind and we're going to buff everybody. And let's put the pikeman there. And what are you going to do? Gain retaliate until the start of your next turn. Okay. He can move a lot. He moved a lot. I repeat, he moved quite a bit. Yeah. I don't mind the fact that you retaliated. We're going to develop our lady. that sounded really wrong, and I apologize. Okay. Ooh. I believe he's dead. Yeah. We have pretty good cards. We've been really lucky on this run. But I want to finish the boss. No! This is another elite. This is particularly like troublesome, just for the fact that we only can attack or move, not doing the two at the same time. So it's problematic. Okay. There's not a lot we can do. The classic setup. And Pikeman, I'm sorry, but you're just there to die. And who is going to get... I believe our champion is... Not enough mana! Not enough mana. Yikes. Now everything is under control. Don't panic. So we can actually move or attack. We can do both. So it needs to be like that. If it's the right option, but there it goes. Just throw everything that you have at him. Uh-oh. No, not a problem, not a problem. I'm expecting him to go near us, but I'm going to go forward in order for him to probably bait the attack into this unit, so next turn hopefully I get the buff for this lady, and I did it, so we won. I can do one. Two, I can do three, and alright, there we go. Nice. This unit, Devour Retaliate. Oof. We're just going to pick the treasure and nothing else, because the deck is working. Even though this is like a good card, but it's expensive. I'm not going to do it. Will I go for the... Let's just give me knowledge. You know what? We're going to leave it like there, right there, because the video is already pretty long for my standards. 38 minutes. I'm not going to spoil all the fun for you. Check out this game, Dungeon Top Spellsword. It's really good. I recommend it a lot. If you like the video, click the like button, and if you want to see more like this, subscribe to the channel. Have a good day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye. Yeah, this game is awesome. Purchase it. Bye.